motion carries.
This right here is what he put out, and that's prob, he'll probably go over this. Did you get one of those?
I probably had it. You have no idea how much paper I go through.
Did you get one?
I don't recall having that, but.
Well, I mean, that's, tells us how we're supposed to act.
It maybe wasn't in a binder.
Lydia off of our, really.
It maybe wasn't in a binder, it maybe was in that packet, and I read it right in the beginning.
Really?
It's the kind of document, I wouldn't expect anyone to read and memorize, but more read it and say, you know, the next time that comes up, I'm familiar with it, and I know to turn to it.
Yeah.
But you're not, I don't expect anyone to.
That's one of the points I'm trying to make is.
I read all of that information, so my inclination is that I didn't feel a need to study it.
Yeah, and we need to be aware of this. The problem with it is what I was trying to bring up, is it has ramifications down the road, what we do. I mean, it, what we do doesn't just end here, and if we, mess it up.
It's just like anything else, Jody, anything we say or anything we do has ramifications down the road.
But if we mess it up, then they could come back and cost the county a whole lot of money. You know, and that's why we need to follow the rules and do it right. So that we are above reproach. You know, I'd like for this, join Pam and say what you just said, that I'd like to see this board be above reproach. And especially in the climate of the way things are going on around, you know, I'd like to see us follow the rules so that we don't have problems down the road and don't get criticisms from people. I'd rather have the criticisms here than in the Atlanta paper.
I don't think any planning commissioner, for as long as I've been on this board, has ever done anything against any rule that they knew that they were doing. That's, I don't know one planning commissioner. Everyone, when any kind of issues come up, we talk with staff, we do whatever we're supposed to do. I think every member that I can ever remember on the board has done the same thing, any issue. Had we known that this was to be the open meeting, it would have been done. I think staff, you would have done it if you thought it was an issue. I mean, I think any of us would.
It's in the paper, it's on the internet, it's everywhere. Anybody that who wants to find out is going to, I mean, you get a call every once in a while saying, hey, you having a public meeting or when or whatever. I mean, nobody driving down the street is going to stop and come in and look around to see if there's a sign.
Well, most people only come to the building when they're coming to the meeting.
And I'm in agreement with what you're saying about it being nitpicking, because it is nitpicking.
But it's the rule.
But it's the rule, and that's where the state, if you don't like that, then talk to the congressman and get them to change.
I don't care.
The rule. Well, if the rule's there, then we need to follow it. We don't need to fight over it.
We need to follow it, but the fact is.
And they've chosen to put the rule, just let me think, they chose to put the rule right here with the planning department. They could have put it after us before it goes to the Board of Commissioners, which would have made our job a lot easier. But since it's here, we have an obligation to follow it. And that's why I'm making a stink over.
The problem is, Joe, there would have never been no stink if you just call, say a week before, a day before, and said, hey, Teresa, you know, I noticed we got to have an 8x11 sheet of paper up by the door over there before we have.
I had nothing to do with any of that.
Yeah, right. Whatever.
Yeah. I had nothing to do with that. I got here.
Do you think you'd like to leave that?
Well, you know, I frankly don't care because I know. You know, I know what I know. I had no idea that meeting was going to get postponed.
Yeah, may I speak?
No, you may not. This is a.
I'm asking the chairman.
But anyway.
We have to vote.
But, you know, it doesn't matter to me whether to leave or not.
Does any.
But the thing, the point is.
Nidia would like to make a point. Does this board want to hear the point that Nidia wants to make?
I don't. We'll read it in the paper or something later on.
Nydia, is it a point that's good for the board?
I believe yes, Madam Chair.
I say yes. Go ahead. Could you turn your video off to make the point?
Actually, it's an open meeting, and so by law, I do have the right to have the video on.
That's fine. I just don't like you talking while you're holding the video.
I respect that. I just wanted to make you all aware that I passed out the little red booklet called Georgia Sunshine Laws, A Citizen's Guide to Open Government, at the steering committee meeting, which was several weeks prior to the meeting that got canceled. So all of you, I passed it out here at the table at the meeting. You may have been out of town that night, although I did leave a copy with Teresa for you to receive, I believe, Mr. Murphy.
Yeah, I got it that night.
Okay, and so I did give notice, and it was me by myself who walked around and looked and noticed there was no public notice posted anywhere in the building, and that is a requirement of Georgia Sunshine Law. Mr. Moses or Dr. Moses was not involved in that.
Have you apologized to the citizen?
The two that were before this board
that night? Have you apologized to them?
You
could have been forthright and brought the matter up and made sure we were in compliance, because we have a desire to be in compliance.
As soon as I realized the lack of compliance, I notified the planning director and the county manager. As soon as I saw it, I notified the county manager and the planning director. Yes, indeed. I most certainly notified them, and they will vouch for
it. Did you apologize to them?
I don't owe anyone an apology. I don't owe anyone an apology. I have not caused the lack of posting of a public notice. That's not my requirement. I don't work for the county.
The citizens who had matters before this board, who were paying for legal counsel to be here, who were paying to try to get something done through the state, you know, and I'm all for the sunshine, but I have this suspicion that you knew in advance, you planned it, and you carried forward.
Mr. Kelleher,
and I'm fine with that.
Mr. Kelleher, as soon as... Mr. Kelleher, as soon as I discovered the lack of posting, I notified everyone I could that was in the building, and that was indeed Doug Dare and Mr. Tom Brown. I was not aware of it.
I don't know.
And I came to the meeting, I looked for the notice, it wasn't here. It is not my job to post the notice. I don't owe anyone an apology. I did not fail to do any job that is a responsibility of this board.
Nydia, I think you've got your point. You got your point across.
Thank you so much for allowing me to speak.
I want to clarify something. But Teresa,
you didn't give the book to me because I wasn't at the steering committee meeting. I just want to make that clear.
I'll give you a copy if you'd like when I have it.
Though you said that you gave it to me to pass on to Matt. Thank you for correcting me.
It was Vanessa Bernstein. Thank you. It was, you were not at the steering committee meeting. I did leave it with Ms. Bernstein to put it in Matt's mailbox. Thank you for correcting me, Ms. Cox.
But the whole idea is just to get...
I have a question for Nydia.
Yes, ma'am.
Is your reason to get us in compliance? Is your reasoning for doing all this to make us a better board?
Thank you for asking.
Because that's what I'm hoping it is.
Yes, indeed. My purpose is education.
And I appreciate that. Roswell's
perfectly educated. They don't need any help.
It's that kind of attitude that really doesn't help this board, Mr. Murphy.
I don't really care what you think, lady.
That's very apparent.
I really don't care.
And that's unfortunate. Because the citizens
do
care.
Because you're a god, apparently, right?
Most certainly not.
Okay.
Most do not. The bottom line of the whole thing is that I've got us talking. Maybe you're upset.
I want Ken Gerard to come in and tell us what, just like the open meeting.
But, oh, I know what I was trying to say is I agree with that. I seconded that motion. And we can read. It's here for us to read. All you got to do is go to OCGA this, you know, and then read this. And that's what he's going to be telling us.
Would
and we just follow the law.
Email that to all of our board members? Can you do that?
You're talking about the state law.
Where you don't have to copy anything.
Well, I can write it down for you.
Just email, and then we'll have it.
Okay, you're talking about just the first page?
I'm just saying the number.
Oh, okay.
What we need to look up.
Oh, okay, yeah, because, and I'm not, despite what Matt's saying, I'm not coming in here trying to control the board or anything. I'm just trying to make sure that we get it right, so we don't have to do it over, and that we're in compliance with the state. I sure don't want to get in trouble and have a misdemeanor charged against me by somebody coming in and
I don't think any of us do.
No, I know, and that's why I'm bringing all this up.
Yes.
And we need to be aware.
If anything has not been followed in the past, at least as long as I have been on this board, and I'm not talking just about me, it has been out of ignorance and nothing else. It's not by lack of wanting to follow any rule to the T. And you have brought that to our attention.
And not knowing, can get us in trouble. And I want to just say to you right here that I particularly appreciate the way that you accepted what I had to say.
All in good faith for making our board better, I have no problem with that. And I think that's my job as chairman, is to make sure
that we move. That's why I referred to.
And that's why I asked for education on it. And I think that's what we need.
Yeah, but, and I appreciate, my respect.
Any other comments?
If it was all about that, you wouldn't be going around tying people to bags. But whatever. I'm ready. I'm done.
Okay, anything else? Is there a motion to adjourn?
So moved.
Second.
All in favor? Motion carries. See you all next week.
Y'all, listen.
Steering committee tomorrow night?
Tomorrow night, yep.
Don't forget, because we don't have our meeting now at 6 before we go up.
6:30.
Don't rush out on me after the meeting. You have to sign minutes and you have to do the homework that you normally did, okay? So after the meeting and after we adjourn next week, hang around, stay up there so that I can get you to take care of some business.